All right, so here we're going to we're going to rebuild the pump. The MagnaFuel ProStar 500. I actually saw a guy on YouTube that actually did a video rebuilding his. And it was kind of inspirational, because if you've never done one of these pumps, you would be curious to know how it's done. So I watched this video a couple of times and I said to myself, I'm going to get ready, because actually this pump I bought a while ago from somebody, and it sat for, you know, months. I had to sit for months, so I ended up mounting it on the car. And after like the second day, it started leaking out of the peephole, just the way he described. So this peephole here, a weep hole, that's where the fuel starts coming out when the seal is bad. So I ended up buying the parts, the rebuild part. Here's the vein cup, and here's the seals. So we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna try this. According to his video, it's something that could be done, nothing major. So the first thing I'm gonna do is, I kind of cracked all this loose already. We're going to remove this nut from here, and we're gonna loosen the inner coupling here, so then we could just unscrew this filter. It's O-ring, so it's a little on the tight side. We're gonna put this to the side, and then we're also gonna remove this side here. I kind of pre-loosened it already, so we got that out. I'm actually gonna take this off if it comes out. Woo! That's on there. Let's see if we can put a little bit of force to it and get this out. There you go. The O-ring's pretty good, because it kinda holds very tight. I'm gonna put this back on here, put this to the side. Alright, we're going to remove half inch drive here. I'm gonna use the 13 millimeter. Remove these two 13 millimeter bolts so we can remove the bracket. Okay. Next thing we're going to do is, we're going to open up the bottom now. I have a screwdriver here. Like I said, I kind of pre-loosened everything up here, so it could be kind of easy for the video. I don't want to waste too much time. This is where the vein pump, the vein cup, is going to be located. It's inside here. So he actually talked about this getting a little rusty and corroded. And if you can see, I'll show, I don't know if this can see it here, but see that? It's a little rusty. So the bolts did get rusty, just like you said. But luckily mine actually came out without a problem. But they're all corroded. Aluminum and steel, I mean stainless steel and aluminum, don't get along. This one was pretty clean. We'll take this last screw out. We're going to end up wire brushing the thread of this, and we'll put a little molly lube just the way he did. Okay, so now this is the plate that removes. I saw him spin this here, so I was curious to know if this cup, if this inner spinned and it touches this, to me it would be some wear for it, but this actually spins here, so that's a good thing. Alright, so we're going to put this on the side, and there you go, that's where the inside of the vein part is at. This right here is what we're going to remove, and this is the cup. I have a magnet somewhere around here, I could actually use this. Oh, here's my magnet here, and we're going to remove the slider vanes, which you can't really tell unless you kind of measure them up. But we're going to remove all of them. And we're going to do this step by step. And put them here on the side. Put this back here again. I don't know if this is steel or not. It doesn't feel steel. So what we'll do is we'll flip this and get this cup out of here. Oh, look at that. Look at that. The cup came right out. This cup came right out and the pin came out. This pin is supposed to actually stay there. This pin's supposed to actually stay there. So we're going to leave it here in this cup. I don't know how good or bad this is. But I'll tell you what, I want to make sure that I took this apart the right way. So that cup's going there. And I went like this, right? So then it's got some notches there. And I'm going to say these notches are opened towards the left side. So I'm going to make sure that I mount the new one the same way. Now, this cup is... He said inspect the cup because sometimes it has a little birds and stuff inside there, but by the naked eye, it does look a little bit worn inside. I know you can't see, but like inside here, you can see a little bit of grooves. All right, so we're going to put this back in here. We're going to set this here on the side. Here's the O-ring. That's in this package. It's got an O-ring there. That's in the package. And the bearing feels good. The problem is when I had it on the car, I had it mounted with this bracket and I had made another template with it and I bolted it to the car and this was up against the tank a little bit because I have the factory tank. And she was noisy. So I kind of thought maybe the bearings were bad on it. You understand? But when it started leaking, what I did was I removed it, let it hang on the floor, and I actually turned the pump on again. And when I turned on the pump without it being mounted to the vehicle, she was quiet. She was super quiet. So I guess I just had it pressed up against the tank, and it was just traveling throughout the car. So now that we got the cup out, this in here looks pretty good. Don't look anything major. Scuffed up or not, and it's still blue anodized in there. So the seal's inside there. So now we're going to remove the motor. We're going to remove this motor from here because the seal's inside here. So with the Phillip, he said, loosen both bolts. We got a different Phillip here. We're going to use this one. He says sometimes these are in their seats too. Okay, that one cracked loose. And this one cracked loose. Now, the guy that made that YouTube video, he explained that don't remove the top part of the pump. He said, don't remove the top part. He goes, remove the whole motor completely out of the housing. So we're going to actually indicate that, the MagnaFuel sign and the peephole. So we're going to actually make sure that the letterings are all facing towards the front. So now we're going to remove the motor, just like he said. He said just lift it. And that it should come right up. So you might have to wiggle it a little bit because of the bearing that's in there. But this one's actually not doing it. I don't want the brushes to come out. Because he said the brushes can come loose from there, which it already did come loose. But we'll be able to put them back. What I want to do is be able to remove this from here. So, wow, it's in there. I'm going to have to tap it. I'm going to have to tap it out a little bit. And maybe use some WD-40. Let me go get some WD-40. Hold on. We're going to spray a little bit of WD-40 in here because this doesn't want to come out of here. And I kind of didn't want this brush to open up and get out of this motor here. both of them. So let's put that back in place. Okay. I don't want this coming out. I want this to stay together. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to try, and with a small hammer, I'm going to try to lift this up and bang that out. See? And it came out. Okay, so we're going to put this here. I actually did not use the WD-40, but I kind of figured it would come out. But here is the bearing. The bearing is, bearing's got some rust on it. So how water got in here must have been condensation from this thing sitting in a garage for as long as it did till I ended up purchasing it. So what we'll do is we're gonna put a little bit of WD-40 in there. We're gonna work it. Oh, there it is. It freed up. It actually freed up pretty good. Look at that, it actually spins. So that's a good thing, because now I don't have to buy that bearing. But listen to it. All we did was spray it up a little bit. So that's a good thing. That thing's moving pretty good. So we'll set this aside. Okay, and now what he said was, I need a rag. What he said was, you remove this, you remove that, and that seal that's in there, what you do is you could pry it up and get it out. So I have a pick tool here. I have a pick tool, a straight and an angle pick tool, which I'm going to try to pick it out without damaging this. But I kind of like don't like how this rusts inside there. So this thing definitely had a condensation where we were sitting. So we're going to clean all that out. We're going to clean all that out. And the whole major thing was this cup. Because he said this cup sometimes is pressed in there pretty hard and it won't come out. So I guess because it's still a little bit of winter, and this is kind of cold, it's kind of, you know, contracted, and it actually slipped out. So hopefully we could slip the new one in there. What I'm going to do right now is I'm going to try and pop this seal out. But I would kind of hate to just go ahead and pry this, because since this is aluminum, I don't want to scar that in no kind of way. But I do see that on this side, if I can maybe use I have like a, not a center punch, but a small chisel here. And if I'm able to get to the inside of here and try to knock it out from up here, from the top part, then I wouldn't have to stick a screwdriver in there and pry it out. But it, actually, I can't get to the back of that. So we're going to try and stick this pick tool behind there and get it out. Actually, it's not that bad. It's coming right out. Look at that. See that? It's actually coming right out. We'll take this and pull it right out. It's actually a complete rubber. I thought it had maybe steel around it, but it's not. It's just actual rubber. So take note on how you remove this too, because there's a certain way it goes. I ended up asking him, and somebody actually asked him the question, like, which way does it go? And it goes with the flat side straight down. So it doesn't have a little lock ring there or anything. It's amazing how it's just a soft rubber. It's not even hardened, and it was still leaking, you know. So hopefully with the new rubber, this is going to work. So here's the old rubber. Here's the old O-ring we're going to place here. I'm going to actually spray some WD-40 in here, so we can clean it up. I mean, we actually need a better rag than what I have there. Let me see what I can find. Here you go. We got something better here. We're going to spray the rag with some WD-40. And we're going to kind of wipe this up inside. I'm gonna wipe it, get it nice and lubed. I'm gonna try to close this up here and stick it inside this hole here. As you can see, I got another camera here actually catching the actual pump, while this one maybe kind of catches me, which I'm not sure if it is or not. Let me just double check that and make sure it's actually catching me. But I'm trying to get this done where we could help everybody. So maybe if you have to do it. Yeah, pretty much it's catching me. We're going to actually bring it up a little bit. Like that. Alright, so we're going to continue here. We're going to wipe the inside of this. Okay. And we're going to put this rag here and take the pick tool. And I'm going to run the rag on the inside where the seal goes and clean that out real nice. All right, make sure there's nothing inside there. Be careful not to scar it. You don't want to scar anything in there. Now on this side, all that rust, we're going to WD the pump and stick the rag in there with the pick. I'm going to run the rag in a circular motion there, back and forth. Like this. Yeah, it's actually cleaning out pretty good. So, like I said, I bought this pump used from a friend, somebody I knew, that's into racing and always had parts laying around in his garage. And this pump actually was for a car that he was building. It was a turbo car. And all this stuff was with it. I actually bought the turbo from him. Also, I got an 88mm turbonetic turbo. And I bought a wastegate with it and some plumbing. I ended up buying the stainless steel upstream headers for 440 big block Mopar. Because in the future, we're going to go ahead and go turbo. But for right now, we're prepping this up for some nitrous. So, we got to clean this up pretty good. There's still rust there on the inside. I don't know how well that's going to come out. Let me see. It's actually cleaning out not too bad. You know. Not that much rust in there now. But I'm going to continue and clean it out a little better. So I'm going to pause the video. I'm going to continue to clean this, you know, pretty well before I go ahead and put it together. So just don't go nowhere. Give me a few minutes and I'll continue when I'm going to put this pump back together. Okay, so what we did was we kind of cleaned it out pretty good. All right, I took a little bit of time. I cleaned it out. We got all the rust out of from inside here. Okay, there's actually no rust on the side surface here. Let me actually grab this so I can show you. Inside here on the wall, all this here was rusted. So what I did was I took a piece of Scotch-Brite, pretty much. I call it Scotch-Brite, but you know what it is. All right, and we went inside here like this and we kind of scraped it up like inside there, went all the way around, got all the rust out of there. Okay, what I also did was on the motor, drop one of these bolts. I'm gonna actually keep everything together. I don't want nothing to come out, so, but I'm actually trying to show you guys what we're doing on the bearing part here on the side of the bearing here. There was rust there too, so what I did was I took some of this and I kind of took some of the rust out of there, put a little bit of Molly lube on top of here, and this bearing's actually spinning pretty good. It's actually pretty spinning real good. So we're gonna go ahead and set this here. Now that I have everything pretty much pre-cleaned, we're gonna go ahead and open the package. I'm actually gonna write the part number down. You can see it there. It's actually backwards because I'm using the selfie phone for that, but I'll write down the part number for this MagnaFuel ProStar 500. Okay, let me actually get a razor blade so we can open it. Actually, I have a blade here. All right, watch yourself. Don't cut yourself when you're opening a package with a blade, especially this one's got a little bit of rust in it. So be careful as you open a package. Make sure you don't cut the O-ring itself. All right, you take it apart. And it comes in a little Ziploc bag. That's a good thing. All right, we'll set this aside. So part number's here. I'm gonna write the part number down on the video. Now we'll slice it here. Oh, again, be careful with the blade. You don't cut yourself, and don't cut the O-ring either. Actually, before we make a mistake and cut myself as I'm trying to prevent it and prevent anybody else from getting cut, we're gonna use the scissors, okay? Can't go wrong. Just keep your fingers out of the blade. And we're gonna slice this open here, going around the O-ring without damaging the O-ring. Okay, let's get all the junk out of the way. And now this should open like this. All right, we're gonna expose. We're gonna take the seal, the small seal. You can see right here, brand new, it's all powdered up. I'm gonna set this aside and we're gonna pull the O-ring out of here. Here's the brand new O-ring, okay? So we're gonna place it on top of the plastic, that way we don't mix the old ring, the old O-ring with the new O-ring. Now, what I saw the guy do on YouTube when he did his was, he kind of wet this up with WD-40, got it all looped up because it makes it easier to go in there, which I honestly thought this was a seal that had metal on the outside part of it, like metal on the outside, but it don't. It's just, it's a plain rubber. You can squeeze it. So it shouldn't be that hard to get in here. So, like I said, remember when you pull it out, how it comes out so you can put it back the same way. What you're gonna do is the flat part, it's got all the numbers and letterings on there. You're gonna put that facing down and put your thumb on there. And you're gonna actually press it in there. Just like that. It actually pressed in there pretty good. Let me see, get a better view there. I'm trying to get some light there so you can see it. See, it pressed in there pretty good and it's flat. See it on the other side, some of it, but you can't see much from this side, but at least on this side you can actually see. And this is the main key here. When one of these pump leaks out of that weep hole, that's the seal that's bad. This is my first time rebuilding this type of pump. I've rebuilt other pumps before, but it's basically the same concept, you know. So now that we got that done, that's all cleaned out, okay, we're gonna actually put the motor on first, because that's how we took it apart. We're gonna put the motor on there, we're gonna put the screws, and then we'll put the cup in there. Now what I need is a wire brush. Because with the wire brush, what we're gonna do is, we're gonna have to clean the thread to the bolts. Now what I notice is, the two bolts for the motor, we're gonna remove them from here, because they do have a little bit of oxidation on them too. See that? They got a little rust, a little oxidation. So we're gonna wire brush that. We're gonna put this aside so we don't get nothing inside here. I'm gonna fold this over. And let me see, I actually need a better bench. I have an actual piece of 3/4 plywood that I wanna put here, because this was something I did up pretty quick and this thing's like breaking up. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna wire brush. I don't have a wire wheel on a machine yet, but this will work. All you need is a little bit of wire brush on here, and you take some of that stuff off. A little bit of the that goo, that condensation, a little bit of rust that's on that thread. Okay, once you clean that, you do the other one. We're gonna actually apply a little bit of Molly Lube on there. Just that way we can try to keep the condensation out, so rust don't build in between there or corrode. Okay, I don't think on the top part we got to worry too much. Just do the bottom part, even though I kind of see a little bit of rust on the top part. But it's not bad. It's actually pretty good, pretty clean. Put the wire brush on the side, open this back up. Okay. We're going to take some Molly Lube here. I'm gonna put our finger a little bit on the Molly Lube, and we're gonna rub it on the thread here. You don't want to overdo it. All you need is a little bit, just so it could go into the thread and keep it lubed. I will go up a little higher on the thread, so that way when the heat hits it, it kind of could spread itself in there. Okay, that's one. We'll set that here. We don't get dirty with this table. Put a little more lube on the second bolt. just like this. Just lube it up a little bit, okay? Place it down. The next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna put the housing back here, okay? We're gonna set it there, and this foam piece goes back in. This foam piece is supposed to go right back in into the same spot. I'm wondering why it's kind of like, it has a shape. It has like a smeared shape, like it's not straight. It's like in an angle, but hey, we're gonna put it back the same way it was. So we're gonna place that foam back in there. We're not missing no parts, right? We got the seal in there. This is actually the old seal, the old O-ring. And I'm gonna pull this back out just to make sure, even though we did do it. New seal's in there and it goes from the bottom anyways. So we're gonna place that on there. We're gonna wipe this one more time here. Okay, on the top part. No O-ring or anything goes here, but the seal's what actually is gonna seal it from underneath. So we're gonna take a little bit of more Molly Lube here, and we're gonna place it on the inside here where the bearing, the outside of the bearing was creating a little rust. So we're gonna put a little bit of, we'll put a little bit of Molly Lube in here. Try to save that bearing for, you know, I don't know, maybe get a little more life out of it before we have to replace it. So we put a little bit of Molly Lube in there. We'll set this pump here. Now the letterings are towards me. Like I said before, we're gonna actually make sure we mount this the same way. Okay, we haven't moved this top piece. So letterings are gonna go towards the front. The 500, the Pro Star is all gonna be facing forward. We're gonna go ahead and we're gonna slide this in here. Just like this. Let me actually show it. Here's the pump, here's the housing, here's the motor. The bearing is already lubed up. We're gonna actually slide it in here. We pass the seal, and look at that. With a little bit of lube, the thing just, it just sat right in there. So now what we gotta do is we gotta fish the bolts through here and find where the thread is at, which shouldn't be that hard. If you hold this nice and straight, they should fall into place. Now let's see if we could actually find exactly where they go. I think I found one and found the second. So now we're gonna screw this in here. Don't tighten the one, just bring it down and then start with the next one. Always do things evenly. That goes down a little bit, that goes down a little bit, goes down a little bit, go back to this first one you started, give it a little crank, second one, give it a little crank, go back to the first one, give it a tighter crank, second one, give it a tighter crank. Okay, so now we got the motor back on the housing, okay? This is actually pretty simple, it's nothing major, anybody could do it. If you're somewhat mechanically inclined or you got good hands, it's not that bad. Okay, so now what we're gonna do is we're gonna open the vane cup, and when the guy did it, he kind of had to take it apart because for some reason he like couldn't sit it in there because the cup actually, well actually, let's see, because I may have that problem right now too. We don't know if this cup is gonna actually just slide in there like the old cup came out. We don't know that. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna remove this plastic from here. Right, I'm gonna take this clean cardboard that it came in, put it up against there, turn this upside down, so then that vane can stay there. Okay, I'm gonna set this down. Now we know that this face that's showing upward is what goes to the bottom of the cup. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna see if this cup slides in there. Oh, not bad. Okay, so the cup does go in there. It's a little tighter than the old one we took out, so possibly with the heat and everything it's endured, it kind of like shrunk, and this one's actually good. I like the way that felt. So what we need to do now is I need to remove this vane from there, and this pin is the guide for the cup, so this pin's got to go back inside the hole. So what we're gonna do is I have needle nose here. There's nothing else on this needle nose here, and I'm gonna try to take the needle nose. I'm gonna do it on the table so I don't drop the pin. I would like to show you guys exactly what I'm doing, but there's a hole. Let me see if I can show you. There's a little pinhole down there, see it? So this pin is going to go right in that pinhole. Okay, and that's what aligns this cup, because this cup should only go one way. So now that we got the pin in there, we're going to actually visualize where the slot on this cup is and where the pin is, and we're going to try to go straight down into it. Just like that. Okay? Just like that. I actually like the way that fit in there. It's kind of nice. You notice how the motor is offset, because that's how the vane works, actually. You know, centrifugal force opens up those the vanes, and that's how it pumps the fuel. So now that the cup's there and this we turned upside down, would it be smart to take this pump and place it over the vanes, because that way I don't have to even touch this. I want to put it in the same way it came. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put this right over. Just like that, take the cardboard, flip it upside down, and I never had to take it apart. Now the vanes are in place just the way it came in the package. You see how they open up and they close? Centrifugal force is how this works. So as it spins, that right there will suck some fuel and push it out the other side. Coming through one side, come out the other side. All right, so let's see if this pump will stay there without falling. We'll remove the old vanes, put them on the side. We're gonna actually take a little WD-40. I'm gonna squirt that. Okay, I'm gonna spin it. Maybe some of it could go inside there. Just like that. It spins actually pretty free. I don't wanna even take this apart. I'm curious to know if there's a washer or there's a little stud here where this runs on. But it actually spins pretty good. See that, how it turns? Okay. So now we'll grab the brand new O-ring, which we put on top of the plastic, which is here. Okay, we're gonna wet it a little bit with the WD-40 that's already on the glove. And we're gonna place it on a groove. It's got a groove here. So we're gonna place that on the groove. Make sure it sits in there properly. Once it's in there properly, then what we'll do is we'll take the plate. Now the plate doesn't really have a direction. Either it goes this way or it goes this way. It can't go like this, so it's got to go either like this or like this. Okay, so we're going to place it right on top of here, and we're going to move this pump to the side. I'm going to put this right here, because right now what I need to do is we need to wire brush these screws, because these are the ones that have more of the corrosion than the long ones. So we're just gonna get into the groove like this a little bit. It doesn't have much, but you want to get whatever corrosion is on there out of the screw. Okay, that's one. We'll take the next one, do the same thing. If you had a wire wheel on a machine, it's actually pretty easy, pretty quick, but you could actually do it manually, because this ain't nothing major, this ain't nothing big. This is something small that, you know, you take your time with it. No need to rush. It's not some industrial type of thing. Just clean the thread out. This one's actually nice and clean for some reason. One, didn't have no corrosion on it. This one's like the worst one. See that? This is like the worst one in here. Oh. So we're actually gonna get a little more aggressive with this one, since it's got so much rust on it. And just clean that out. That way when we put it back in there, you understand, it's not that tight. And we're gonna put some Molly lube in there. So we're actually gonna lube them up. That way this don't happen again. Now again, fuel pumps are not supposed to sit. When you put a fuel pump or a carburetor up on a shelf and it sits there for months or years, it's most likely 100% it needs a rebuild. It's never something you're gonna put on and it's gonna work. So it's never recommended. And when you do store a fuel pump or you store a carburetor, a fuel pump, you actually, you want to put some WD-40 in it when you store it, because that way you drain all the fuel out of it, you make sure it's dry, and you put some WD-40 in it. And that way it'll stay moist, it'll keep the rust or water from building, from condensation. It'll give it a better life for the next time you need it to work. Okay, so now that we got two screws on here, that pump will stay right there. I'm actually putting a little bit of lube, a little Molly lube on the thread, okay? Just like this, and put the screws back on. Got the last one here. We're gonna do the last one. I'm gonna put a little bit of Molly lube on that, okay? I hope this radio is not that loud, because I don't wanna get copyrighted. You understand? It's just that I like to do work with some music in the background, as always. That's why I continue to talk, though, you know? Don't wanna get copyrighted. You gotta keep the rules as they apply for YouTube. Since I'm gonna put this on YouTube, so I can, hey, listen, maybe I could help one of you guys. Maybe you plan on doing this. Maybe you have a pump that's leaking, and you know, instead of sending it to somebody and having somebody charge you, I'm actually showing, because the guy that did this video, there's a guy that did this exact same video, which is where I copied from, and was able to do it myself. I think it was great. You understand? He gave a lot of information. There was a part of the cup that he kind of skipped, because he said he had to put it in the refrigerator, in the freezer, and froze the housing, and then that cup slipped right out. So then I kind of asked him a question that maybe it would be smart to freeze it again to put the new cup. So I was under the impression that the cup had to get pressed in, or you had to put a wooden block in there and bang it in. But as you see, when I took this one apart, the cup came right out. There was nothing actually holding the cup. The cup came right out, and the new one went right in. So here we are. Hey, four screws again. I did one, did the second one, did the third one, did the fourth one. Not tightening none yet. You want to actually always bring things down evenly. Nice and flat, evenly. You don't ever want to crank one screw first and then the second screw. You bring them all down first to where they don't go no more. Okay? And then you apply some pressure. Let me see if I can use a bigger screwdriver. There you go. Then we'll put some pliers here. We'll apply some pressure. Pliers. I was thinking of, you know why I said pliers? Because I was thinking of putting pliers at the end of the screwdriver, but I don't know how many know this. But these screwdrivers, let me see if I find a wrench here that fits. These screwdrivers, I don't know if anybody knows, but these screwdrivers actually are made for you to put a wrench on here. I don't know if you knew that. But I don't have a wrench big enough to actually show that. I don't know the size, but I do know that you can actually put a wrench on the end of this screwdriver, but I don't have nothing that big, okay? Like if you were to take an adjustable, see that? Fits nice and square on there. Okay, so we're gonna use the adjustable since we're already talking about it. We're gonna snug the first one. We're gonna snug the second one. We're gonna snug the third one. And we're gonna snug, oh, I didn't put pressure downward. So you gotta put pressure downward. There you go. Okay, so we're almost there. We're almost there. Let's close this Molly lube so we don't get no particles in there. Always keep that grease clean, okay? Move this to the side, move that to the side, because we're almost done. The pump's actually rebuilt already. I want to keep this rag on here because this wood here, it's got some wood chip that come out of it, makes it kind of messy, okay? I'm going to wipe this up here, wipe the top, get this pump looking brand used again. Okay, so there you go. Now the filter, all right? I don't know if a lot of you know this, but I didn't know it, and I had to do some research. This is the return, okay? This is a regulated return system on this pump. So this always faces towards the front of the car. This don't go towards the back. This is the front, because this pump doesn't have an in or an out. Like most fuel pumps, will tell you in and out. This pump, when I got it and I was looking at that, there is no way to know which way where's the inlet and where's the outlet. So after I did some research and I got a manual off online, I got online and got a manual, and it actually says that this is the out, this is the in. Okay, so wherever this bypass, regulated bypass is on the pump, that's the front part of it. Okay, so this is the fuel filter that goes pre-pump. So from the tank, it goes here, from the filter to the pump. So we're gonna screw this back on here. If I could actually thread it. Before I thread, I'm gonna put a little WD on the O-ring, so that way it'll help it squeeze itself in there. See how easy that went in? If you try to do it with a dry O-ring, you're liable of catching that O-ring and kind of pinching it and damaging it. So now we're gonna place this down. We're gonna give it a little snug. Use the pump itself so you can put a little pressure on there. So let me just make sure I did that right. Okay, then we're gonna turn it around this way. We're gonna use the pump and we're gonna tighten the nut for the filter, which I'm gonna back it out because I heard the O-ring seems dry. So we're gonna spray that O-ring with WD-40. We're gonna put the nut back on there. And we're gonna snug the nut. Oh, okay, so we loosened it, but at least the nut's tight. Now what we'll do is we'll use the pump again. We'll close the crescent wrench and we'll lock that in, okay? Now on the out side, on the out, we're gonna put this fitting back in there. Little WD-40 on the O-ring. Okay, we'll screw it back here in place. Now we'll set this down. We'll take the adjustable wrench and we'll snug that up. Again, using the pump as leverage, put a little pressure on it. It doesn't take a lot of pressure. It's just a little bit just to get it tight, because the O-ring actually does a good job. And we'll take this piece here, we'll put a little bit of WD-40 in there. Oh my God, I sprayed the speaker. And we'll screw this one back on here. Take your time, don't cross thread nothing. Once it starts, a little bit of WD on the O-ring. Okay. And again, we'll use the pump as leverage. And just give it a little snug. That should do it. And there you go, man. I want to thank that guy that did his video. And I actually don't like the way this wire is turning in there, but that's why they got that on there. They're a little stiff. I'm going to try not to move that too much. But there you go. This is how you do it yourself, man. You can rebuild your own pump. You buy the kit. You watch a YouTube video, which is very, very helpful. I mean, today's day, the stuff that we learned, there was no internet back in the days. I mean, I am kind of admitting I'm kind of old. You know, I learned stuff from before there was any internet or any computer or anything like that. We learned the hard way. Today, you Google, you go to YouTube, and if you got some abilities of using tools and have somewhat a little bit of knowledge, you could do it yourself and save yourself some money. So there it is. Here is your MagnaFuel ProStar 500, brand used, rebuilt. It's ready to get put on the car. The last thing we got to do is we got to mount the bracket back on here. Put the screw here. And we're going to put the other screw and use this as a ground. Because that way you don't have to run a wire, a ground wire to the body. Since this is going to be mounted right to the body of the car, it's going to ground itself with that. 13 millimeter. Go snug. Don't ever tighten the screw first. If there's two screws, bring them both down. Do one, do the next one. If there's four, bring all four down. The only time you just put one screw and you tighten it is if there's a single screw. So you turn it, make sure that's seated, seat it, and then we'll give it a little crank, a little crank. Remember, you can't crank them too hard because this is our aluminum housing and you don't want to actually strip it. The bolt's stainless steel, so the housing is aluminum and you can damage it. And that's it, guys. That's it. I hope this is helpful. I will actually put the part numbers down onto the video, maybe at the end or in the beginning. That way you know what part numbers go for the rebuild of a ProStar 500. And this cup, like I said, this cup, for some reason, the guy that did the video, the cup didn't walk right out. But I got lucky, this cup walked right out. Okay, there's the main O-ring and the seal. Believe it or not, the pump, this pump is like, what, almost $500? If you buy a used pump, as long as the motor's good, you're good to go, because you just buy this kit here and you could actually rebuild it. So it's not a bad deal. I heard that these pumps only last one season, two seasons before you have to rebuild them again, which that kind of sucks, because something that costs almost $500, you expect to get a few years out of it. At least, let's say $100 a year. You understand? So it should last at least 5 years, but that's not the case. You know, this thing gets hot, gets cold, gets hot, gets cold. Even though it's a full cycle duty pump, you know, things happen. And then over the winter, if you're not in a heated garage and this thing sits in the car and the car is kind of cold, you know, it's gonna create condensation, and that's where water comes in and the bearings get fucked up. But that's it, man. Here we are. I'll put the part numbers on the video. Here's the seal. And you guys stay safe. You know, we're dealing with this COVID-19 situation. Everybody is quarantining. I'm in my garage. My house is 5 feet away. Actually, 10, 15 feet away, because the garage is detached. So I actually got to come in here and find things to do, because you go crazy after you clean so much in the house and you help the wife out, the trash, the this, the that, the TV, the laying on the couch. It kind of gets to you. So I've had things that I've want to get done, which the car, if you see my other videos, you know I've been working on the car. I got the nitrous hooked up and we're ready to go. This is the next thing that's going, is the fuel pump, because I did mount this fuel pump and it ended up leaking. So I had to put the blue Holley back on, but now we're going to put this back on. We're going to put the fuel cell up front, and we're going to get the nitrous fuel side working, so then we could actually test the nitrous. So there you go, guys. It's something you could do yourself. I hope this has been helpful. And thank you for watching, man. Don't forget to subscribe. I'm trying to get a couple of videos out there to help everybody, since, it, you know, when I need something, I go on YouTube and I see stuff that kind of does help me. So I want to do the same. I want to return the favor. So thank you very much. Thanks for watching. And don't forget to subscribe and hit that like button. Thank you.